Okay, on to the big voice for the day. Mr. Anil Agarwal, Group Chairman at Vedanta Resources and Chairman Emeritus Sesa Sterlite, joins us right now on the show from New Delhi to talk about mining and the road ahead for that sector and, of course, his individual companies as well. Good having you, Mr. Agarwal. Thank you so much for joining in. Now, you know, with the new government talking the right words, the world is quite bullish on India. Do you see India going back to the old growth rates if indeed the government can push for reforms and get the investment cycle going?
As far as the, I think after Mrs. Gandhi, Indira Gandhi, this is what they're really seeing, they're believing, the tremendous positiveness, tremendous excitement anywhere in the world. I think 6 billion people all know, by and large, that the Modi government has come in the strong power and something going to happen, India going to, after, on the last 15 years, the world has worked on the China. And I think the momentum, if we can create for India on back of China, the world will go very far.
India might be looking up, but the world economy is still in doldrums, never mind what the German data showed yesterday. And that probably doesn't augur too well for spaces like metals, for crude. What is your expectation on metals as well as crude?
I think this is an opportunity for us. This is an opportunity for us because our consumptions, forget about the West, 1/10 of the China. You know, if you take the aluminium, we only produce 2 million ton of aluminium. China produced 27 million ton of aluminium. The whole world is half of the steel will be converted for the aluminium. Iron ore, you know, Mr. Modi has gone to Australia. It was agriculture country. Today is entirely depending on the natural resource. We used to produce 170 million ton of iron ore. We are only producing 100 million ton. And India can produce 600 million ton, which can change the country, create the tremendous job and eradicate our poverty.
Right, Mr. Agarwal, what's the status of mining in Goa and Karnataka and how soon can you start mining there?
Very unfortunate. You know, I always said that the stop discrimination in India between public sector and the private sector. If you look at the public sector, NMDC, they are running it comfortable. Private sector has been shut down. You know, the last 2 years, there is no production of iron ore in the country. At least the rupee today, what it is, somehow they blame because of the iron ore. We used to have almost $7 billion foreign exchange, which has been stopped. Hundreds of thousands of people are jobless. So the court has said to start the production as early as possible. It is the high priority that we should take it very seriously and start the iron ore mine. I believe the work is going on, but it has to be expedited. It has to be taken on war footing to take whatever has been clear to open up this mine.
Right. So what about, the timeline for restarting these mines?
As long as we get clearance, we can start. We all are ready to start. We need, but it's very unfortunate that one thing the government must do, not to discriminate. Discriminate we have seen in oil and gas, we see in the mining. The government company, they have allowed ONGC to do the shale. Private people can't do it with a similar property. It's very important that level playing field must be given in general to everybody.
Are you also talking to the new government for the need to scrap export duty on iron ore in the face of sliding prices globally?
You know, see, this is Goa iron ore is a very fine grade. And the iron ore price has reduced, almost lost 40% of their price. It is absolutely bit unviable to trade in this iron ore. And if this duty is not removed, it is impossible to trade on or to manufacture iron ore. So I hope government will take a view on this.
Okay. The other new, of course, that information that I wanted from you, that because the power minister has talked about getting the power sector back in shape. He also hopes to have 25 UMPPs. Do you have any plans of tapping these opportunities?
About the power, we are very large in the power. We produce almost 10,000 megawatt power, and this is our focus, and we are looking mainly more reform to come in the sector.
The government is keen to open up coal mining for commercial use, and we now hope for clarity in coal mine allocation as well. Would you be interested in foraying in this field then?
Yeah, we have coal and coal. The whole world is, look at us when we import, if you go to the port, only coal being imported all around in India and being transported for thousands of miles. This government seems to be very serious, working very, very hard to put them, to open up this mine. We will look at the terms and conditions, and hopefully we are the best miner in the country. If you look at what we are doing, we will look at the opportunity.
Right. Mr. Agarwal, you recently had a discussion with the finance minister as well on buyout for residual stake in Hindustan Zinc and Balco. Without giving any details, if you could give us a sense of how your meeting went, and are you hopeful of closing the deal, say, in the next 6 months?
No, this is, the hope, most of this, 67% of the world money is invested in the stock market. And, this decision affect the company share, which is very valuable. And government has announced and cabinet has cleared. Government is very favorable. I believe I met the finance minister and in general, and they all are looking, and they said that this is very important, top of their agenda. And I believe this should happen. And we are not looking to acquire the shares ourselves. They are looking to divest in the market as the auction route. And whatever we want to clean up, we want to move forward. And I think government is serious, and hopefully they will move forward.
So with diesel, Mr. Agarwal, being decontrolled now in India, is retail petrochemical an area that Kane could look at foraying into, or is it going to stick to pure oil and gas exploration play?
No, we are not in refinery, we are not in retail, we are very, very upstream, we are very focused to remain, whatever we have done so far, whatever company we have taken, whether the aluminium company of Balco, we have increased production for 6 or 7 times, they have given us a zinc company, we have increased production almost 10 times, we are the people who discovered the silver, we are producing 25%. Silver of the on the country, same thing in the oil and gas. We produce probably the lowest cost of oil in the world in our field. We have discovered gas. If you see, the best of technology has been brought in. What we are looking to simplify the system, allow us to give us a level playing field. Give us parallel position than the ONGC. If you want to create ONGC, and we should be parallel to see who can do better. And I'm sure we all will have a very healthy competition. And I'm very confident. We'll put heart and soul, because most of the 83% of the revenue goes to the government. It can really eradicate our poverty. It can create a huge job. What we are looking is simple policy, so we can produce more oil in this country.
Let's focus on Kane, of course, for a bit more. How far away is Kane India from achieving the 33 lakh barrels per day production target from the Rajasthan fields, and are all government approvals in place for the same?
Government approvals are in place, but the simplification of the system, whereby, because we have to make an investment. So I've always said, once you've given the well, give the well to the lifetime. Why to create 5 years or 10 years? Because once you're given, if somebody is doing the right work, up to the life of the well must be given them, so they can make a long term plan. We are not been able to do the long term plan. All our certification should be self certified. Why we have to go? I mean, it would be very very good if government allow, and this they are considering to self certification. All these things happen. We will be in position to produce 300,000 barrel or more. Also, the gas which we will be producing. We have incurred 1,000 crores for developing this well. We are looking the reimbursing our cost for small technical reason. We have to go thousands of time to explain. This all has to be removed and make a simplification. And company like us, there should be 30 companies to come to in India to explore oil and the natural resource, so we can eradicate our poverty. If you look at all over the world, you know, whether you go to North America, Central America, you go to Australia, Middle East, all has developed and eradicated their poverty, created a job because of their natural resource. And there is a time now for India to focus on that and allow and invite most all over the people from the world and come and invest and look at our natural resource.
Mr. Agarwal, so good chatting with you today, and thanks much for taking time out and speaking with us today on ETNA. That's Anil Agarwal speaking exclusively with us. Let's...